Ask Reddit by Montasio. What's 100% a scam but we accepted it in our society? That dental isn't part of medical insurance by default. Same with eye care. If I can't see, I can't do anything, and I'm practically blind without my glasses. I'd have died in the era before glasses were invented. A fee to pay your bill. Service charge. Subscription services for fucking everything. It does annoy me. I think Adobe was one of the first to do it. I originally would have paid about £400 for all the software, as a student anyway. That's already a lot. But I owned it all. Now I'm basically paying £600 a year for it. Sure, it might get all the latest updates and features, which are now getting better and better, but it's still a lot. I cancel, I lose everything or have to find an ancient copy of the software. Unfortunately, the fact they can just rake in money now monthly means it's not changing back. The only things this is good for is places that do monthly subscriptions, paying as you go each month. I download as much music, SFX, video clips, templates, etc. as I can and make the most of that month of downloads, then I don't need anything else from them for ages, if ever. That health insurance doesn't cover your eyes or teeth. Arbitration clauses in almost every service provider contract. Tricking you into giving up your access to the court system. Nobody talks about it, but they should. A lot of employers make you sign arbitration agreements too. The right, or refused right, to repair. Absolute bullshit that I can't fix my own shit. Tried to replace the blower motor on my AC unit in my house, four screws to slide it out and a wire harness to unplug. Turns out I need a HVAC license to even buy the replacement. I don't have an HVAC license. Service fees on tickets. The whole ticket industry is so infuriating. Unpaid lunches that extend your workday. One place I used to work would bring lunch for the last 3 days of the month. If they provided lunch, they didn't have to pay overtime for an hour. They were known as hostage lunches. Convenient fees on electronic payments. Biggest insult to everyone's intelligence. Pay this extra fee to give us money electronically without needing to pay an employee. It costs so much more for the computer to do it. The price of printer ink. Laser printer, my friend. Ticketmaster. I was looking for tickets to pro hockey game. The ticket price was $108 and the Ticketmaster fee was $83. Needless to say, I didn't buy the ticket. Diamonds. Thank fuck my wife is a geology nerd. I picked out a raw uncut diamond ring for her and saved heaps. Since a lot of people have asked, it was purchased on Etsy for less than $500. That specific storefront no longer exists, but there are several alternatives. They claimed the stone came from a mine in northern Canada, although I have no way to verify that. Do some googling, you'll find a bunch of examples. https://cdn.shopify.com/s/files/1/2463/8905/files/rawdiamonds.jpg ?1571656944. Keep the alternative non-traditional ring suggestions coming. Claw machines. I went to the arcade with my daughter and picked up 6 prizes with 6 attempts. Quit while we were ahead, I swear that thing was broken. TurboTax. They lobbied the government to make it difficult to do taxes without their software. I lived in the UK and it took literally 15 minutes to do taxes on bad government software. The IRS offers a free alternative available on their website for most people. The IRS also has no advertising budget. Hence why nobody knows about it. College Bookstores. FC K McGraw-Hill. Expensive engagement rings. Diamonds and jewelry in general. Paying hundreds of dollars per month for health insurance and then insurance not paying for anything until you've hit your deductible, usually thousands of dollars per year, and then after hitting your deductible insurance only paying for a certain percentage of your care until the end of the year until your deductible resets and you pay out of pocket all over again until you hit the deductible, and even after hitting the deductible your insurance is fighting tooth and nail not to cover anything. Best part about insurance is when my doctor says I should get something, then some middleman who got a bachelor's in accounting 20 years ago can come in and overrule him. And I pay him for the privilege. For-profit prisons. Payday loans. Went through a hard time years ago, ended up having no other options to get money but a payday loan. Was stuck in the cycle of pay off loan and take the same amount for another week to get by. For probably close to a month until work picked back up enough and I could pay it off and have some extra to survive till next payday. Never ever 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 again. Ever. That it's considered normal to spend tens of thousands of dollars on a wedding ring bachelor party. Deleted. Luxury skincare, go to a dermatologist, pay less, get real results. Tretinoin and sunscreen, baby. Plus a heavy duty moisturizer and CeraVe healing ointment for my lips, my derm's most recent recommendation and a godsend. Most high-end skincare contains other components that are also helpful, but there's a margin of diminishing returns on price, starting pretty low, and b, you can even purchase the constituent ingredients. For example, squalene, ceramides, hyaluronic acid, AHA BHAs, etc., in their pure form for quite cheap at this point. Proof of consistent rent payment does not improve your eligibility for a mortgage. Edit, just amazed at the number of upvotes on my completely wrong comment. You can have your landlord report your on-time rent payments to the credit bureaus. There are companies that help them do it, like Rent Plus. Diamonds, wedding rings. Every kiss begins with K, right? Caskets. Most funeral services MO. They try to upsell you so much it feels so wrong. Bottled water, Coke, etc. SIM activation fees. Mum influencers using their kids as bait to advertise products. Absolutely despicable. Reddit awards. Deleted. Middlemen brokers eating up the profit and inflating the prices in pretty much every business. Health insurance providers have entered the chat. Political promises. They keep the ones they make to our owners. America's tax return system. I don't think it's a scam, but the price is like $4.99, when it's clearly $5, but they know most of the people will tend to think subconsciously it's $4. I like when the fuel price at the pump is $3.49 9/10,